My name is Justin Townsend. I'm a lighting designer and associate professor at Brooklyn College. ETC has asked me to add a few words with this release to help frame this new piece of equipment. Normally, we'd be able to hold and touch this new light and see it ourselves. But now my son is on the computer in second grade, my wife is directing a play in the room next to me, and we haven't gathered as an industry in over a year. It's a strange time, but we know we'll be back. So I'm honored to try and give this a bit of perspective and insight to which this new light offers. I came up with ETC. I programmed the vision and now Broadway's, but then 86 red F-150 driving Kevin Barry, teaching me how to hang shins in a tiny dance space at Smith College. I turned on those old, beautiful 360 off-axial shins to 30%, and I was sure I was a lighting genius as the dancers popped to life and humanity. Luxurious, golden, rich, warm light carving the dancers. I went to college as the Source 4 was invented, that crisp, clean light and oh-so-silky shutters. I slung those lights first as an electrician and eventually as a designer all over the country, learning how to finesse and push those units. They became the workhorse of my design for years. I assisted Chris Ackerlin, watching him make the Obsession 600 Sprint, driving all eight parts in blind while the SM called the next cue to stand by. Now, on Broadway, I'm working with ETC on their EOS TI to push the parameters available, and with Brad Gray, uncoding completely unique magic sheets, pushing their tools to the limit and then asking for more. I've brought my students at Brooklyn College to the early conversations about augmented. And during these brutal, challenging times, the free Nomad software has given myself and my students a light lab to continue to work and play in. ETC has been a part of my career from the beginning. Their creative work and invention has allowed my work to grow and develop. When I first met with them about speaking now, I thought, after all of the amazing things you've done, I get to talk about the light with an extra LED in it. And at first I thought, okay, yeah, you added a red light. I get it. Better red. I like red. Yeah, I can talk about that. Bloody, bloody Andrew Jackson. American Psycho. Jagged Little Pill. Moulin Rouge, The Musical. Clifton Taylor's must-read book on color and lighting design talks about the limitations that we inherit, what each tool can and can't do, right? Physics. We're all familiar with the problem of wanting our CMY high-intensity discharge moving lights to suddenly hit red. Even with red glass, that delicious arc source behind it doesn't produce the ancient red waves that I ache for. I want to point out why I think ETC is leveled up again. So yes, we can get deeper reds, hurrah. We know they exist. I've always been an R27 person myself, and finding that deep red accessible now becomes essential. But we know through additive mixing that putting this extra diode gives us a bigger color field, right? A deeper color field. That with their other colors, including the lime green, we are now filling out the spectrum. I'm reminded of MP3s. I absolutely love vinyl, and I love my mother's old Rolling Stones albums, but they don't travel all over the world well with me. This additional diode allows the smoother output of light, a curve with less steps and spikes. Finally, we have a light that can make a rich tungsten spectrum. I turned on this light and I was brought back to my days behind those 360 off axials. It was a deep gut reaction. Not an emulation of the color, the fullness of that fat, dusty tungsten beam and all of its rich golden color. When I saw the quality of light coming out of my test unit, I was brought back to those golden shins when I started lighting dance. So yes, in some ways, just one more LED, yeah, but also a remarkable change as well. A light that can give us tungsten. I'm thinking about a few things. Touring. When I sent out the Humans Tour, we had to double hang lights. I could get the porcelain L201 and L174 out of the LED ellipsoidal, but then I had to double hang a tungsten source 4 with the same focus to get the quality of a real light bulb. I wanted that delicate color, almost egg tempera light painting-like, that the tungsten allowed. internationally. Bringing Moulin Rouge down to Australia, the country will not allow tungsten lights to be used. They're not environmentally sound. These Luster 3s allow the design to be consistent and beautiful wherever we go. Clearly, we have to advance our work environmentally. I'm grateful to have a tool that responds to better energy consumption. Education. Education can keep it simple again by eliminating complex layouts for DMX runs and networks. When I started designing, it was only a power cable running to a dimmer. That was a pretty low entryway into our industry. It meant we ran a lot of mult. But it also meant the thinking was relatively simple. Plug a light into a dimmer. But now the rig requires a network layout and comprehension, data and hot power to each light. I find that early career designers don't just move a light to where they need it. They make do. The cabling needs and networking challenges are too complex. Now, with a wireless patch and controlled light, moving a special from the first electric to the fourth electric is fast, simple, and doesn't even involve patch. Plug it in where you need it to work. 17-year-olds are back in the game with a lower bar of knowledge to be able to start to play and engage with the light. I use education as an example, but who else can't benefit from the simpler network layout? Tools determine design. With RGB LED light, I light a red well, blue well, cyan, magenta, right? But white? Each generation of LEDs has given us more spikes, right? Or places color can land. But the palettes have seemed small. Other colors can be found, but not rich, right? They make a million different colors, but somehow only seven look great. I'm reminded of David Byrne's book, How Music Works. In it, he suggests CBGBs and the architecture of space, right? The room the music was made in, influenced how the music sounded. What sounds good in that long tunnel, low ceiling of a space with strange angles and boxes? It's a different sound than, say, U2 mix that sounds amazing in an arena. So I've been thinking about Christmas trees. In our house, we celebrate by having a tree, and I grew up with delicate, clear white lights on a natural tree. Iconic. Simple. When it came time this year to replace my lights with LED, I was unable to find a light source that I loved in my mind that would work well with an all-natural tree. So instead, we changed the whole tree. This year, we had a silver tree with tiny LED balls of light. Lights that, as you know, do red, green, blue, cyan, and magenta, as well as a sad yellow. The ability of the light and its limitations changed the tree itself. Without really thinking about it, because I couldn't get the quality of light correct to match the scenery, I changed the scenery. The lighting design changed because of the tools available. So now, with the color field open, the Luster 3 brings us back into conversation about color that has more finesse, more precision. We can once again use those beautiful golden tungsten qualities and fat saturated colors. The color field again opens up, not just to deeper reds and honest tungsten, but all colors now have a smoother curve and richness. I thought I'd end us here on a Rothko. A reminder that red, and really all color, is a complex idea. Red isn't simply red. The depth and delicacy allow us more detail and precision. We aren't simply happy to make it red. What kind of red should it be? What specific color should we be making? We don't need to default to the colors the light can provide. We get to choose what we want. Our ability and equipment has shaped our design, thinking, and habits. What will our next conversations and ideas about color be with this new precision? Color has been a tool for us in this LED revolution, but the center of the design strength has been in the light's saturation. With this tool, we're given back the swatch book, back the depth and variety and delicacy of color that has the richness and depth in the way our lights did with a filter in front of them, and the added ability to hit the brilliant rich color on a zero count. ETC has once again leveled up our conversation, not just giving us another tool, but a way to create new designs and work in new ways with color, having more precision and finesse. The color, networking, and ease of use makes the Luster Series 3 our new workhorse. Thanks again for sharing a moment with me. I hope this finds you and your family safe and healthy.